horses and gear. Gonna rope the dummy a little bit today. Try to talk about our daily vlog, some of the things that we do, some of the things that we pride ourselves in, some of the new things that we're learning. You know, I've been roping my whole life and have learned a few skills. Now I'm learning a few more skills about the art of roping, and especially the art of Californio style roping. But today we're going to try a couple things. We got a brand new, we got to throw a shout out there to Cactus Ropes. Cactus Ropes has been building the Cactus Buckaroo. This is a 60 foot, it's an extra soft nylon rope. It's built in a 5/16 size, which means I have a girl hand, and 60 foot of rope in a 3/8 size is just more than I can really comfortably handle. Granted, I'll be holding on to some bridle reins and, you know, doing some things there. So having just enough that I can hold on to a bunch of coils and be able to do my thing and handle a bridle reins and a horse is very important to me. But a couple days ago we got in some rawhide hondus. I'll kind of give you a pan up close here what the rawhide hondu is. Y'all can see that. Spins around, it's tied on a Turk's head knot. You kind of see that right there. It's tied on the end of a Turk's head knot. It pulls through. This hondu essentially can spin all the way around the rope, but supposed to allow me a lot of, you know, some longevity to this rope. Allow me to do some cooler things as we start swinging through here with some things. Today I'm just going to kind of walk through some just basic things that I do about every other day. I'll come out, I'll rope the dummy here, practicing some of these shots, and it's a myriad of shots, just kind of every other day. If I get the opportunity to come out and rope the dummy, I'm going to rope the dummy. And when I was learning the team rope and rope in general, you know, I rope the dummy every day, shooting for that. And then the second hondu, the second project that we worked on, this was the very first Cactus Buckaroo rope that I bought in the 5/16. I love this thing. As you can see, I'll bring this up here. As you can see, I've about wore out the first half of it. However, I have 60 foot of it. So I thought, what the heck, I'll turn it around and use the other half of this rope. On this one, I put on a different style of rawhide hondu. Notice it doesn't have the neck. It just kind of goes through there. This is varnished. It's very hard. It's very open. It's a lot lighter than I expected it to be. More than likely, this will be my catch rope, and I'll use it as a catch rope for say. The hondu will never cinch down. It will never close down and choke a horse. If I were to rope a horse with this, that hondu's always open, always allows me to you know, alleviate the slack. And the best part about a rope, especially with young horses, is you know, it can apply the pressure, but as soon as the horse releases the pressure themselves, the rope never misses. My timing can be off a split second, but the rope's timing is perfect. So some neat things I'm gonna work with, but like I said, today's vlog, I'm just gonna rope the dummy and follow along with us, and I'll be running a myriad of shots. And if I think about it, I'll try to, you know, let everybody at home know, you know, I'm gonna try this shot or the name of this shot. Just some different things, but come along with us, we're up the dummy. I think first, yesterday I roped first with this one. I think I'll leave it till the last. Really like to get this one broke in. It's a brand new rope. It's never stretched a cow. It's a brand new hondu. I think I'm gonna rope with this a little bit and try to get it broke in more. First shot.
Oh, Prescott, I know, just riding the Bronx in the big rodeo. Springtime, Philly, I find, and I may spend all summer with her on the mind. But I'll never be branded, I'll never be broke. I'm a carefree range rider, a drifting cowboy. I'm rich, but I'm broke.